Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lynett and the tourism channel. So as you can see, we have the amazing Miss Tourisms here with you, and they have a specific unique trait to both of them. They both come from the Eastern region, so they are both Miss Tourisms from Busoga. I'm going to give them a chance to introduce themselves, but before we go any further, subscribe to my channel if you have not over there. Hit me up in the comment section. Let me know what you think about these amazing beauties. I'm going to share their social media platforms in the link. But first, let them introduce themselves. Hi, girls.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
We're fine.
Thank you.
Please tell us, who are you? Who are you? We have met you before, but who are you? Who is everyone?
Okay. Hi, guys. My name is Rose Sandra and Abagana. I'm the current Miss Tourism Talent Uganda and also second runner-up Miss Tourism Busoga Region 2019-2020.
Okay, nice to meet you, Sandra.
Nice to meet you. Yeah, hello everyone. I'm Cherifina Bridget and I'm Miss Tourism Uganda 2019-2020, as well as Miss Tourism Photogenic Uganda.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, so girls, tell me, you're both Miss Tourism from Busoga.
Yeah.
You're both Busoga.
Yes.
My mother is Busoga.
That's so sweet.
I think that's where you got the beauty. The beauty from Busoga.
Yeah, guys are crazy. Every Busoga I tell tells me that.
Every Busoga is beautiful. The most beautiful women in the country.
Yes, so tell me about the culture of the Busoga, the unique culture that we can sell as tourism products. You're both in tourism, so am I. I love the industry and I love culture in itself. What can a tourist coming to Uganda enjoy from the Busoga region as culture or as sites and attractions? Let's start with you, Sandra.
Okay, we are going to talk about the entertainment part of it.
Okay.
When you come to Busoga, trust me, you're going to enjoy the beautiful traditional dance, the Busoga dance.
Okay.
The Busoga dance has a lot of, you know, beauty in it, that it brings out the real beauty of a woman from Busoga region.
Okay, so how is the dance? How does it go? Is there like a rhythm? Is there a song that you can give us from the Busoga dance that
I wish you had that.
Being cool or something?
I wish you had like some music around, maybe you would listen. I would like it.
Involve it and listen. That they sing when they dance in the Busoga dance.
Yeah.
Tell me.
So we can dance here. It's a very good one, but it involves most of the, you know, Busoga in their dance, they have some different kind of, categories. We have the Nalufuka part of it. Nalufuka is so fast that you shake the waist so fast, it runs so fast. Then we have the Tamena, we call it Tamena Ibuga. So it's kind of the breaking, you break the waist, you twist it in different ways. Then we have Elongo. Elongo is basically for danced in most cases during the twin ceremonies.
Yes.
Yeah, so during that time, there's a way they twist it slowly, take it slowly, and it brings out the real beauty of Busoga. And it shows how soft the Busoga women are.
Sandra, thank you. Thank you. We need to market other women. Sandra, you're crazy.
Even other traditional dancers in Uganda, of course, they have meanings. So that is true. Busoga. When we cross to the other tribes also, they also have meanings. Yeah.
True. So, I mean, you guys have the Chabazinga. Yes, tell me about the culture, the line of power in Busoga.
The highest trunk is the Chabazinga, who is next to the Katiki, no?
Is he single?
No, we can't say that.
But you have the Chabazinga, but okay, right now we all know he's single.
He's young.
Okay, let's not discuss
him. He's single because he has not yet married anyone, but it's not good to discuss high ranks. So it is the Chabazinga followed by the Katikilo, then the Pite Katikilo. Then we have the different chiefdoms. We have 11 chiefdoms.
Do you have clans?
Exactly, we have clans.
Okay.
Yeah, for example, Yame, Mwise Mukasa, and then
Mwise Ilombe,
and you
Ngavi.
Anyway, yes, we do have clans.
Yeah,
from the different chiefdoms. different chiefdoms have different chiefs. These chiefs act as representatives of the Chobazinga in all these different chiefdoms.
In the kingdom.
Yes, so we have 11 chiefdoms. Then from that, that's when you bring in those.
And now the king now comes from the Gavula chiefdom.
It is the ruling chiefdom. It's so called Gavula chiefdom. From Kamuli, it's the ruling chiefdom we have right now. So anyone you hear saying I'm a Mugala, just know that one is a prince or a princess.
Just like that. Okay. Tell me the culture food of the Busoga.
It is Emboli and Mvuluga.
Emboli and Mvuluga.
Yes, put it in English, that is sweet potatoes and a junat paste.
Hey, what about Mugoyo?
No,
it's not the real, it's not the traditional food. The traditional food mostly is Emboli
and Mvuluga.
Always new Mugoyo, which is sweet potatoes with beans.
That is just another delicacy we have, but it is locally Emboli and Mvuluga.
Okay, tell me about the tourism attractions in Busoga region.
We have very many
and beautiful. Let's first welcome them with a bridge, the new bridge. It is so nice. When you're just up there, you take some good photos and you will see the real beauty of Busoga region.
Yeah.
So that one welcomes you automatically to Busoga.
Not to talk about the longest river. Who has it apart from us? River. We have the source.
We have its source where it begins from.
Yes, so we are naturally gifted from the source that we talk about Kaguro, because it's where we originate. It is believed to be the first settlement place of the Busoga.
How, like the Busoga, like where did, like they first lived under the rock?
Yes,
they came from the rock.
Yes,
they first settled at the rock. It's believed that when Omukama Kabalega came, he first of all settled at the rock. Actually, when you're at the rock, you're able to see the almost the whole Busoga. Kingdom. Actually, the whole kingdom when you're at the rock. So. And then it's so believed that he had different sons, and then these sons had sort of like disagreements. So what Omukama Kabalega did is that he tried to put out these agreements, these disagreements, he divided up the sons. He was like, you Gabula got this aside.
That's how we came up with the kingdom.
Every chiefdom is the name of a son. So they were like, you go and get that land and you rule that land.
So
he had 11 sons and then he divided them up. So Kaguro is the first settlement place of
Busoga.
And I didn't even know any of these things. Like, even my mom's Busoga and I'm just finding out all these things.
You should go and visit the place.
Really,
I think after
nice.
We should go. We should do domestic tourism.
Okay. As Miss Tourism is Busoga, we're trying to encourage people to carry out domestic tourism. What do you think which is a must-sell product of Busoga, of domestic tourism, but packaged in Busoga culture? What should it entail? What shouldn't we miss out? But do you guys have like Senga and Koja things?
Yes, we have them.
We do.
That is part of the culture. We have
them. It's part of our culture.
That's why you see that the Busoga women are cooking. Like, they don't just, get divorced. Because they are groomed by these uncles and the Sengas, the Kojas and the Sengas. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You have them?
Yeah, we do.
Is there any specific thing they teach you that the Baganda don't teach?
No, let's not compare like Baganda and Busoga.
Senga matters are already more like bedroom matters. So.
Not only that, but also, they teach you to be stronger despite the situation in your marriage and to be patient.
Resilience.
To be patient and prayerful. Yeah.
Prayerful. Wow. No, me, I really like to learn about different cultures. I'm always looking to improve my personal abilities.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's great to learn. It's great to learn.
Yeah.
So, you were telling me what's the last thing that someone should not miss out when they're coming to Busoga region. You've talked about the Kaguru Rock, you've talked about the source of the Nile, you've talked about the Bishop Huntington.
Yeah.
What else?
The entertainment.
In Busoga?
Don't forget about
Mabira
the entertainment.
The dance,
of course,
yes.
The traditional
dance. Food.
The food, yeah.
What's your dress code? Gomesi?
Gomesi.
And
we put on Gomesi and HTV.
HTV. Busoga is HTV.
It's called HTV in Busoga.
So it's the Gomesi. It brings out the real beauty of Busoga woman. And it is the culture wear for Busoga region.
Sandra, I am loving this. I'm loving your passion for the Busoga region. So, where can people find you as we conclude? We have 30 seconds.
For those who would wish to go with us to Busoga, they can get in touch with Miss Tourism Uganda Foundation and also get in touch with Miss Tourism Busoga Foundation. Yeah. Oh, when you like, you do follow us on those pages, also on Facebook, then you will get to know which person you can contact.
Which are your personal pages that people can find you?
Okay, my personal page is Miss Tourism Talent 2019 Nabagala S. And then for the other page is Rose Sandra Nabagala. Okay. Get me there.
Where can
for Instagram.